In less than 9 months, three men, one former employee at Google working on DeepMind, and two former employees at Meta, created an LLM that is beating Claude, Gemini, and is really, really close to beat GPT-4 in different benchmarks. The company is called Mistral AI and already has a $2 billion valuation. They have created multiple LLMs and they are in the right path to beat GPT-4. Hey friends, welcome back to the channel. I'm Donna, a software engineer and AI specialist based in Sydney. And in this video, we are going to explore the reason why Mistral AI has the potential to surpass GPT-4 as the leading large language model. For that, we need to understand two concepts: the number of parameter and MoE for mixture of experts. Also, if you would like to test Mistral to see if it beats GPT-4 in your use case, I will leave a link in the description for you to go and try it out. Now, let's talk about the number of parameters. Imagine an LLM not just as a software program, but as this colossal machine teeming with billions of tiny little switches. Each switch is a parameter, but here is where it gets interesting. These aren't just any switches. During the LLM training phase, each parameter is precision tuned, sort of like dialing in the perfect settings of a high-tech device, all based on a massive amount of text data. Now, when we feed a sentence into an LLM like GPT-4, it's like we are setting off this chain reaction within the machine. All these little parameters, these billions of switches, they work in concert. It's this incredible teamwork that enables this LLM to understand what we are saying and come up with responses that can be truly and amazingly accurate. The real magic of LLMs lies in how these parameters interact, shaping the way it predicts, comprehends, and crafts language. But here is a critical point. The bigger the LLM in terms of parameters, the more power it needs to run. This is where the concept of mixture of experts, or MoE, enters the stage. I know that mixture of experts sounds like rocket science, but the idea behind it is surprisingly straightforward. Think of MoE like a team of super specialized experts. Each one is a master in a different field. Imagine one expert is a wizard in the field of medicine, another one is a math genius, and another one is a maestro in music. Now, when you have a question for a large language model that uses MoE, it's like putting these questions through a smart routing system called gating network. This system figures out which expert is best for answering your specific question and directs it to them. So you're always getting the best response. Let's take a real-world example, the Mistral 8x7b model. This model has 8 experts, and each one of them packs a whopping 7 billion parameters. That adds up to a total of 56 billion parameters. But here is where it gets really interesting. Even with all of these parameters, Mistral 8x7b doesn't use all of them at once. At runtime, it only fires up 2 experts. That's just around 14 billion parameters in action. This means it's way more efficient, using far less resources. But keep in mind, while it's more efficient in operation, the storage size is still for a 56 billion parameter model. As for the computational power needed, like GPUs and CPUs, it's more in line with what you would expect for a 14 billion parameter model when it's up and running. The exact terminology for that is total parameter and active parameters. In short, the MoE approach in LLM is all about getting the best of both worlds, specialization and efficiency. It's about tackling complex tasks without having to keep the entire machine running full blast, optimizing both performance and resource consumption. Now that we understand the basic concept, let's look at how many total and active parameters GPT-4 and Mistral AI LLMs have. But before that, if you like this type of content and want to learn more about the wonderful world of AI, please leave a thumb up and subscribe to the channel. There will be a lot of other videos like this one coming up. In boxing, fighters are categorized by weight classes to ensure fair and equitable competition. This approach ensures that opponents are matched accordingly to their size and weight, thereby creating a level playing field and enhancing the integrity of the sport. I think we should get inspired by that and implement a similar system to compare models depending on their number of total and active parameters so that it is fair. That benchmark does not use any system like that, and we will see why they should in a second. So stay alert, it will blow your mind. I will be taking some shortcuts and speculations, so don't take the numbers exactly for what they are, but just to give you a rough idea. While Mistral Medium hasn't explicitly disclosed its parameter count, there are some speculation online that suggests that it might be an MOE of 8x 30 billion parameters. If we assume that two experts are run at a time, that means we have a 240 billion total parameter with 60 billion active parameter LLM. Mistral 8x7b instruct has only around 56 billion parameters and 14 billion active parameters as it uses two agents at a time. That means it uses around 4 times less resources, CPU, GPU, and storage than Mistral Medium. Now let's talk about the giant GPT-4. According to rumors, GPT-4 is estimated to be an MOE of 8x 220 billion parameters. That is totaling a crazy 1.76 trillion parameters. If GPT-4 MOE uses just two experts at a time, that is 440 billion active parameter, which is around 7 times more than Mistral Medium and 28 times more than Mistral 8x7b. Returning to the benchmark list, Mistral Medium and Mistral 8x7b instruct are impressively high ranked despite having significantly fewer parameters and using fewer resources compared to GPT-4. This is the reason why I think that they might beat GPT-4 in the long run, as they are already really close to do so with an LLM that is 31 times less demanding in resources. In fact, you can run Mistral 8x7b with the following hardware. This means we are getting closer and closer to run LLM on our laptop or even phones. The future is close, and that's really exciting. If you find this content interesting, please show your support by giving a thumb up and subscribe to the channel. In an upcoming video, I will dive into the 3 benchmarking methods used in that ranking to evaluate various LLMs. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.